Hello, this is Christy from Graphicious. In today's video with Camtasia, we're going to work with Camtasia 2021, and I would like to show you a little trick with Camtasia to create bullet points. If you're trying to get away from PowerPoint and you do a lot of presentations and you have like bullet points to show and you want those to be revealed in, you know, different times, and you want to keep the bullet points on screen and you want to do this without PowerPoint, this is a very easy video to follow. And we will be looking at a new feature in Camtasia 2021 that's going to help speed up that process. It's possible to use this same thing in Camtasia 2020 or 2019 and previous versions, but this new thing that was added in 2021 is going to help you speed up the process and make everything more reusable. We're just going to go here in Camtasia. I have a new project open, and I'm going to go to annotations. You can see my canvas here is all black, so I don't have any content on the screen at this time. So what I'm going to use is I'm going to use a simple text annotation. I'm going to drag this onto the canvas here, and this is going to be the text of a bullet. So we want to do these bullet points so they are reusable. So the first thing, I'm going to just make more room for this text in here, and probably I'm not going to use the same size. So for bullet points, if you want to have like 5 bullet points on screen, they have to be a bit smaller. Depending on the amount of text you want to use in a bullet point, you know, you want to make this smaller. Maybe this size is fine, like 66 points or let's say 60. And one tip you want to do, just so you know, you want to make these bullet points probably aligned to the left and also to the top. The reason I'm saying this is because you never know what bullet points you're going to need and how much text is going to be in each bullet point. So you want to make them all expandable from the top left, so that if you have multiple lines in a bullet point, they will nicely wrap onto the next line. So this is an example. This is a bullet point, and it goes on to 2 lines or even 3. So you can see this bullet point has 3 lines. And the idea is that PowerPoint, when you have bullet points, they nicely align to the left, and the actual bullet point stays on the outside of this. So that's the reason we're not going to include the actual bullet in here. So I'm going to just leave this as it is. I'm going to make it a bit wider. So let's suppose that this is the width of a bullet point. Now, I want to also create the bullet itself. I know Camtasia doesn't create it for you, so that's the secret for having them aligned properly. So I'm going to go to the annotations again and move to this tab here with the shapes, and I'm just going to grab one of these white rectangles. I'm just going to keep it simple. I'm going to make a white rectangle as a bullet point. Just make it small like this. And the idea is that it is a single line, so the bullet point will have to be a single line of text. If you want to resize it proportionally, just hold down the shift key, or if not, you're good to go like this. So this is my bullet point. Let's make it a bit smaller here. So there you go. So that is a simple bullet point with my text. Now, you can make the text bold if you like. That's fine, up to you. It looks nicer like this with bold. You can zoom in, of course, and adjust the bullet point. Maybe it's a little too large like that. So there you go. That is it. So you have the bullet point and you have the text. Now, how can we make this reusable? So the idea is that we will create a library asset that we can reuse in our projects when we need to have bullet points. So if we want to have 3 bullet points, 5, 1, 2, 10, whatever, we will reuse the same component over and over again on the same screen, on the same scene if you want. We can have these appear at different times. So one other thing I want to do is I want to make the reveal of this text be interesting. Maybe you can do like a fade in or whatever, or you can go to behaviors and you can use one of these behaviors that are pre-built with Camtasia. So I do like this one that fades in from the left. I can use this one, or you can use the pulsating one. Depends how interesting you want this to be. And of course it can be replaced later. And I'm going to just use this fade. I'm just going to drag it on top of the annotation or down in the timeline, which I'm going to zoom in a bit now. So watch what happens with my bullet point. So So this is how the bullet point appears. You can customize the in, during, and out events, for the duration of this. So in, it's going to fade, as you can see. For the in, it fades in, and then it stays there for a second, and then fades out. So if this is how you want to do it, that is fine. Or you can probably take out the out event and just say none here in the right. So right now, it's going to just fade in like this from the left nicely, and it's just going to stay there until it runs out. So this allows you to make this bullet point stay for as long as you like by changing the duration at the end of the clip. So we have a bullet point, we have a nice coming in kind of behavior, and we have the white bullet itself. You can make this interesting as well. Maybe you go to transitions, and let's say we want to choose like a glow and apply that to the shape here. So while it's fading in, the bullet point kind of glows. So look what happens. Like this. Maybe it's an interesting, or you can add a behavior to that one and just make it bounce or whatever. So keeping things simple, now we have the bullet point. How do we reuse this? Because if I just select everything and just copy and paste it, it's just going to make a duplication of everything on my screen, and that is fine, but then everything has to be taken care of so it doesn't get lost and moved by mistake. And you have to change your text as well. So I'm going to delete my duplicated copy and show you how to do this. We want to make a component, and in Camtasia, you can make a component from anything and group it maybe, or add it to your library directly. So this is exactly what I'm going to do here with this element, with the bullet point attached to it. So this is my text. I'm happy with the font. I'm happy with the color. I'm happy with the size of the bullet and everything. So all I have to do now is just select them both on the timeline and group them. You can press Ctrl G, or you can select right click here and group. So this is my bullet point now. It has moved into a group. I can now move it on anywhere on my screen because it's a single unit. I can still go back in and open this group and make any changes I like to it, including double clicking on it to change the text. When I'm happy with this, I can even rename this. If I open the group and double click on the tab here, I can call it bullet point, like that. So I have a nice component, it's a group, and it's a bullet point with text in it. So what can I do now to reuse this? Well, one of the things that Camtasia introduces is access to quick properties. So before I add this to my library, you can look in the right side here, and you can see that the bullet point properties, this object that I have, has now this text here. This is the text of the bullet point, and the callout, and the color, and the font. So before, in previous versions, you could only access these quick properties fields from specially built components that Camtasia was giving you in like their library packs or annotation packs or whatever. But now this version introduces access to these, by yourself. You can create these yourself. And watch this. This text here, without even opening the group, without double clicking on it and kind of figuring out where it is to type new text in, I can just click in here in the text and say, this is bullet point one. Press enter, and it updates the text on your bullet point on the screen. So this makes it much easier to have access to the content and the text, and also makes it nicer for these to be turned into shareable assets. If you're happy with how your bullet point is behaving, what you can do now is add it to your library, because these properties are available here. So you can change even the color of the bullet point from here. Look. So they are customizable beyond just, having to double click on each one of them and kind of changing it inside. I'm just going to leave it to white right now. Let's do this. Right click on this group and say add to library. I made a presentation library here, which has nothing in it. And I'm going to just use, you can use canvas size, which is going to add this bullet point exactly in the place it is now. So when you bring it in again, it's going to place it in the exact same place because it records the canvas size, or I can say use visible size. So it's just going to save this object. When you bring it in, you can move it anywhere. So I'm going to use visible size. Click OK. and there it is in my library. So right now it shows you this icon on the left that it has customizable properties on it. So let's see, I want to add two more bullet points. I'm just in my library right now. So let's suppose that the first bullet point has been long until here. I'm going to drag another one and place it right here. So this is my second bullet point. Play that and it comes on. You can move it so it aligns with the other one. And why not? Why don't we just add another one here like that? Put it here. You can't see the beginning of it because it has that behavior that comes in. So if you want to play with them before, you know, you want to arrange them to where they need to be, maybe take the behavior off. This is, you know, three bullet points in my timeline. You can see them here. So if I play my project now, you can see the first bullet point comes in, the second one, the third one. You may notice that my blur animation here on one of the bullets is getting cut off. That's because they are in the group. What you can do to prevent that is right click on the group and say resize group to canvas size. So that makes every one of these bullets not be constrained by the canvas, by the actual little group canvas that's created inside. You just say resize group to canvas size and they all occupy, they all have the same space available to them. So now they don't get cut off anymore. Watch what happens. They all appear in a nice fashion like this. This is a nice cool thing. In previous versions of Camtasia, you could change the text by double clicking on the object to get inside of the group and then double click again on the annotation and bullet point two. You can change the text like that. Well, this is much easier to do now in Camtasia 2021 because look, I'm clicking on the group itself and automatically on the right side, I have access to that text just like I showed you before. Let's do the third one, you know, bullet three, just click in there, bullet point three. These are the three bullet points and you're done. So this is much easier now. One other tip I have for you, if you find yourself that you often use 2, 3, 5 bullet points and you don't want to have to manually add each one of them every time you need to put 5 bullet points or 3 bullet points, you can create an asset in your library with 3 bullet points already built in. So watch what happens. I am on my timeline and I'm going to move all of them to start at the same time. So you can see them all in here coming in, all three like this. So watch what happens again. You see that in the right side, every time I click on one of these, they expose the text that's available inside of that particular bullet point. But watch what happens. If I want to save an asset that has 3 bullet points by default, I group these three together again, select all of them and control G, and check this out. Now each one of them inside of that group appears in the same screen. So I can change all 3 bullets at the same time in one go. So I have them all in here. So when you bring your bullet points from PowerPoint, you just bring this up in here, drag this 3 bullet point asset onto your canvas, put the text in here for each one of them, and you're done. One note though, you notice that only one of them has the callout, rectangle, and color changeable. The reason is Camtasia thinks that I didn't want to save that to the library like that. So what you can do is you can click on this little icon, open quick property editor, open that, and you can see here the ability to take out some of these properties and you make them uneditable if you like. So if I want the callout color to not be changeable anymore, I can just remove it from here. Or if I want to add the other ones in, look, there are 3 callouts in here. I can click plus on all 3 of them. You can even change the order of these fields like that. So there you go. Each bullet point now has a text that is customizable and a default, you know, a callout. You can even change the label of this field. So let's say bullet point text. You just add a label for them so that you know exactly what you are changing. I change that on all 3 and click save. So watch this. Bullet point, bullet point, bullet point. It may not be enough room for me to show those in here, but you get the point. You can now customize all of these in one go just by grouping them together. So when you're happy with the way this component behaves, why not right click and add it to library? So now I have a 3 bullet points component, right? I'm going to use canvas size this time because I don't want to have to expand all those groups every time. Click OK. And now my library has a 3 bullet point. If somewhere in another presentation or in another video, I want to put in here a bullet point with 3 points, I just drag that from the library and here they are. And click on this and all of the text fields are easy to customize. So this is a much, time-saving feature. You don't actually have to manually create all these bullet points. If you have a workflow like this where you need to do a lot of these components and bullet points and other assets coming in from PowerPoint, it pays to actually create them the first time, save them in your library, create the proper fields that you want to customize, and just reuse them anytime. And you still have access to move them inside and out, left and right, get them to start earlier or later, depending on your presentation, just by opening this group here. So look, I'm opening the group. So now, because all three of them start at the same time, that's not very interesting, but you can take one of them and just move it to the side and make the other one start later on. And just like that, you've created 3 bullet points that come in at different times. And you can expand this for your entire presentation and just move them about. And when they are about to come out, you know, leave the screen, you can also do that. You expand the group, you go inside and you say, you know what, bullet number one has to disappear right about here. So you can go in here, maybe go to transitions, maybe add like a fade out or whatever you want to that particular bullet point. And watch this, it's gonna leave the screen just by itself. So that you're done with that one. So I hope this tutorial was useful. Thank you for watching. Thanks for your time. If you find this useful, subscribe to my channel, like it, comment. And if you have any questions or Camtasia tutorials ideas, I'm actually looking for ideas right now. If you haven't upgraded to Camtasia, there's a link in the description for that. Thank you again for your support and thank you for your time. See you next time.